Hi there, welcome back to the next ClickSense tutorial video. And in this tutorial video, we are going to look at the ClickSense field value count function. So this is a very simple function, and this basically returns the number of distinct values in the field. And the field name must be given as string, for example, a quoted literal. All right, so how we can implement this? So this is a simple data set where we have region, we have year, we have month, and we have sales. And let's say, for example, we want to identify how many unique region we have. So what we can do is we can create one variable, which is region count, maybe, or region unique count, whatever making sense from the business perspective. And we will say field value count, I think that's the function, and then we need to give it as a literal, as it was specified in the definition. So we will give the name as region, and I'll hit the save. So what it will do is it will store the value of the region, which is over here, into a new variable. So whenever you have such a need where you want to count the unique values of a particular field and want to store it for, let's say, later in the day, later in the, you know, week, you want to have a plan to develop some more calculations based on this variable, you know, you can go ahead and use that. So whenever you encounter scenarios like this, you can use the field value count function. So hit save, load the data. Data is loaded successfully. So we'll click close, come to analysis, and I'll just take a quick KPI, add a measure. I'll go in the expression editor and I'll use the evaluation, the dollar sign, for the purpose of evaluation of the variable. And the variable is region count. All right. And it has given its value also over here, if you see too. Click apply. So region count is 2, and we can check that as well. So we have north and south, so that means it is absolutely right. So that way you can use the pretty straightforward field value count function. It's just that having an idea about this will going to save you from a lot of different expression like a normal count function along with distinct, which takes a lot of resources and memory when it is calculating, and it may delay your scripting. So that's about it, and now I'll meet you in the new video, the new topic.